Hello and welcome on my channel, Wolf Aqua, your channel about horticulture, aquaponics and aquaculture. And today I'm going to show you the third episode of Aquaponics, my story. And in this episode I'm going to show you how I built an aquaponic system for school, or for the school where I studied back in those days. And let's go! So, next to learning from my final high school degree, back in those days, I stepped forward to my school and asked, "Hey, you have a greenhouse there, but there's almost nothing in it. So would you be interested to have an aquaponic system?" So, and I did a presentation and talked to the head of the school back in those days. And after some talks and some time, I got the green light to build the aquaponic system. And I made an agreement with the school in such a way that I pay, build and run the system, and in return the school is paying the running costs like electricity, and I was allowed to use the labs to do my research on the aquaponic system. And so I built this system. For the tanks I used very classic IBC tanks like so many DIY systems using, and I painted these tanks twice with black color and then once with blue color, just to prevent the light is penetrating towards the roots or to the fish, just to keep the light out a little bit. The first two tanks were the grow beds, and then the water was going to the sun tank, and then from the sun tank back to the fish tank. The fish tank is the last tank in the back, which was a little bit more elevated to get a better gravity flow of water through all of the system. And this is how the finished system looked like. I tried to build in the biofilter inside the fish tank. And the type of biofilter should become actually a moving bed biofilm reactor. However, I noticed very soon that my air pump was way too weak to really bring also here all the media into suspension. The media I used is so-called Helex, and it was a floating type of media. So, and the idea was actually, since a moving bed biofilter needs to get aerated anyway, it can also aerate at the same time the fish tank. Well, in the end, the whole biofilter was more like a static floating bed of biofilter media which got aerated from the bottom. But anyway, in the end of the season it worked pretty well, and my fish had always nice clean water and good water parameters. So the water flew from the fish tank over a solid lift overflow into a screen filter. That screen filter had 50 millimeter or 2 inch in and outlets. Unfortunately, I just let it build them so small. Today, nowadays, I would have loved to have bigger in and outlets to transport or to move more water. Anyway, you always keep learning. The mesh size of that screen filter was 300 micrometer. And after the screen filter, the water got dispersed over the two grow beds. And from the grow beds, the water flew back to the sump tank. And from the sump tank, through a heating system, back to my fish tank. As a plant growing system, I utilized a so-called deep water culture, so DWS, and where the plants actually grow in net pots. And so the plants grow in the pot, and then after some time, the roots go in the water, and from then onwards, they take the water and the nutrients out of the grow bed itself, actually. As stocking material for the fish, I used my own produced offspring. This was a red Nile tilapia. And I produced this Nile tilapia with a YY super male, and because of that most of my offspring was male. And that's actually very desirable for tilapia because the males grow faster and bigger compared to the females. As plants, I utilize cucumbers, physalis and bell peppers. As you can see, they actually did very well and they liked the system. But there you have to keep in mind, for the first 2 weeks, or 3 weeks, depending on the climate and what kind of plant you choose, you need to water them by hand until the roots are long enough that they really reach the water underneath the net pot. And also, the fish felt actually quite well in the system, though I really noticed that it's quite unpractical to have the biofilter, at least in the way I did it, inside the fish tank. Because when you want to catch out your fish, they immediately hide behind the filter or below the filter, and then it becomes very tricky to work with your animals. However, the water stayed over the season in very good conditions and crystal clear. The plants grew very well, and especially the cucumbers and physalis really liked that system. And to give them some support, we put some strings on the IBC containers up to the ceiling of the greenhouse to support plant growth and to train them a little bit upwards to the ceiling. And soon, you could actually really see strong root growth at the bottom of the plants. And this was also reflected in the vitality and the growth of the plants, which was very, very fast. And after some time, you already could see the first mini cucumbers, and also the physalis started to set fruits. For the pH adjustment, I used potassium and calcium hydroxide, so I alternate these two. And I also added chelated iron to feed my plants with all the, nutrients needed for proper plant growth. So at the beginning, actually, I had my air pump standing on top of the fish tank. But one day I was just listening to my fish tank and I noticed like, that's actually very noisy for my fish. So since then, I moved the air pump above the fish tank to have a more quiet environment for my fish. At the end of the season, the plants actually reached under the ceiling of the greenhouse and quite some nice big cucumbers got harvested. And also the fish grew well, but stayed a little bit smaller than I expected. Here's like a footage from the beginning of the season when I did a small feeding session with them, and they were actually always hungry when they saw me. Furthermore, you see here like a few shots of the plants and of the roots, how they develop in the deep water system. The cucumbers were already all harvested while the physalis still remained in the system. The physalis became way longer than 2.5 meters. Unfortunately, we had quite some rodents in our greenhouse and they really loved our physalis fruits. So in the end, I just got a very few physalis to eat myself. The majority of fruits were eaten by the rodents, unfortunately. For me, it was super exciting to see how many roots a plant can produce in 1 year. And in this deep water method, you really can see all the roots produced in one season. And another nice thing is, this system is way easier and way faster to clean. Back home in my own system, I used expanded clay peppers, and it was a mess to clean this up at the end of the season. Here, in this deep water system, I just took up the plant or the net pot, I cut the roots, and then just fished out the roots out of the water, and that's it. So it was super easy and fast to clean. And while preparing the system for the winter time, I noticed that the water distribution over the two grow beds was not 100% equal. One grow bed had much more sediments than the other one. So definitely that was a point to optimize for the next season. And at the end of the season, actually also the fish made it still to a nice table size. All of the fish were completely nicely red colored, had no dark spots, and they tasted very delicious. And through various connections, I was able to visit one of the first aquaponic research experiments of the University of Rostock. And back in those days, it was still the old greenhouse. Nowadays, they have a really nice high-tech glass greenhouse with several different recirculation aquaculture systems to do aquaponics testings and experiments. And also in the same year, I was able to visit my first indoor commercial fish farm, also a recirculation system. And in that farm, they grew African catfish. And it was very interesting for me to talk to the farmer and to figure out how they're going to produce their fish. And as in the last videos, here are the learnings of that season that I did. So putting the biofilm inside the fish tank is by principle a good idea, but it's very unpractical if you want to work with the fish, at least when you set it up the way I did it. The air pump should not stand on top of the fish tank because that's very noisy for the fish. An equal water distribution over your grow beds should be reached so that all the plants get the same amount of water and nutrients throughout the season. So this was the third episode of Aquaponic My Story. I hope you really liked it and you could learn something from it, or you got inspired on how to build an aquaponic system. I would be very, very happy if you subscribe my channel and leave me a like. If you have any feedbacks on the video content, the video quality, just post it in the comment section below. I'm always happy to get feedback. And that's it. And I would be very happy if we see each other on the fourth episode of Aquaponic My Story, and see you next time. Bye.